Our next award honors the outstanding teachers in golf. Since 1986, the 2013 Illinois PGA Teacher of the Year Award goes to John Andrews. He is the PGA teaching professional at Pine Meadow Golf Club in Mundelein, Illinois. The Teacher of the Year has to be someone that really knows the mechanics of the golf swing, understands when to be a coach, kind of like what Lloyd was saying, gets the mental side of the game, and is a great communicator and promoter of the game. Mr. Andrews is this kind of teacher. He created a patent-protected putting aid called the Hurdle, created a junior club fitting system with Mizuno, designed a putting studio with 11 different camera angles, and published several teaching articles along the way. Maybe most importantly, Mr. Andrews promoted and coached the junior league team at his club. He is growing the game through teaching. He not only teaches swing mechanics, but he also teaches his students how to become better players. He is a creative teacher, not just one size fits all. His students don't just improve. Coach John inspires them to do what want to frequent the facility to practice, to play, and to learn more about golf. Mr. Andrews received a glowing letter of support from a student. It was a perfect depiction of someone we would see as a teacher of the year. He successfully took the father, the writer of the letter, from a 30 handicap down to a 9 handicap. Took his beginner child to a successful junior tournament player, and his 12-year-old golfer all the way to a visit to Stanford University. These are unbelievable accomplishments for these people. What I found most interesting about what the father said about John is that he was impressed with how his son's friends also picked up the game because of John's impact and influence. What an inspiration this teacher is in our game. Please give a round of applause for our 2013 Illinois PGA Teacher of the Year, John Andrews.
As a father, my daughter got married a year and a half ago, and to give that speech, to stand up there in front of a couple hundred people, and I turned and looked at her, and my mind went blank. And I'm standing there, I didn't know what to say. I was looking at her, she looked so beautiful. So fathers, look out when you have to get up and give a speech and at your daughter's wedding, because it can get really tough. So tonight I hope I do a little bit better job of going over what I'd like to talk about tonight. There's three different areas, three things that I really love: golf, my family, and my wife. I'd like to start tonight by reading a letter, a Christmas letter that I received from a young lady. She sent me this letter. She said, "Dear John, I just wanted to thank you for all the help you've given me this year. Whether it was advice on my swing or on my mental approach, you always come through. It's really nice to have someone to count on when you feel lost. You've been there like a second father to me when you've given me advice during my tournaments, and for that, you've earned my respect. I never would have accomplished what I have so far without your guidance, and I can't wait to keep working with you this season. God bless you, and Merry Christmas." That meant a lot to me. That's why I teach golf for a living, to get those kinds of letters and to get thanks from the adults and the juniors. It means a lot to me to stand there day in and day out on the driving range and try to improve their golf swings, but to really get those letters really puts a tear in my eye and a lump in my throat. Tonight I have a few people that I would like to thank, friends of mine and fellow golf professionals, the IPGA staff for all their hard work. They work tremendously hard, and I truly do appreciate them. Thank you. The awards committee for all the hours that they put in all the candidates' information that they go through. It must be very difficult because we have so many talented golf professionals in our section. Thank you for selecting me, and I am honored. All the golf professionals that have nominated me in the past years, I've been nominated before for Teacher of the Year, I thank them. I would like to thank my students for all the ones that I've improved and all the ones that I have not. All my students have definitely helped me become a better teacher, and I thank them all. Two of my students who wrote wonderful letters to the awards committee, Kim Dickerson and Ken Anderson, I thank them both for writing such beautiful letters and helping me to achieve this award. My mentors in the game, in this goofy business we call the golf business, a gentleman by the name of Bob Judson, who was the general manager at St. Andrews Golf Club many years ago, who passed away in 1998. He gave me my first golf lesson. He was a great friend, and I miss him. I'll never forget, as a 16-year-old boy, at St. Andrews, they had a field, and you go out there and hit your balls, and you'd pick them up and then put them in your shag bag and hit some more balls. And I was out there hitting balls, and Mr. Judson came down, and he was hitting balls, and I walked over to him, and I said, would you mind taking a look at my golf swing? And he said, sure. So he comes over, and I've probably hit about five or six balls, and he gets my attention, and he looks at me, and he says, John, I want you to take 2 weeks off, then quit altogether. And as a 16-year-old, I'm sitting there, and I'm trying to just soak in every word he's saying. He's like, John, that's a joke. Okay. But it was great. He truly was a great friend. Ed Tucker and Steve Waugh, who were the director of the general manager and the head professional at Amelia Island Plantation, they gave me my first job in the golf business, and I was very fortunate enough to work for them, two great golf professionals, and I stay in touch with them currently to this day. Golf Digest instructors. I worked for Golf Digest for many years, but they honed my teaching skills. Without them, I would not be here today. My close friend and a man I admire and respect a lot, Mark Winkley. He truly understands the golf swing so well. John Elliott, who is by far the most creative teacher I've ever known. And then also Jack Lumpkin. He is a man that changed how I thought of myself and as a teacher and a player. I was an intern from the PGA. I went to Ferris State College, and that's how old I am. It's a university now. I was down at Amelia Island as an intern, and I was fortunate enough to help Jack Lumpkin at the driving range for his golf schools. And at the back of Long Point, there were two different tiers where you could hit full shots from. And I always put Jack down on the lower range, and I got there early, got the bags out, the balls out, everything set up, so I could sit behind him and watch him teach, because I admire how a great teacher he was, and I knew a little bit about him. And so as he would move along, I'd sit there and I'd move along with him. And then one day he turned around and asked me, or he walked back and he asked me, he said, what do you think? And I'm like, what do I think? I squeaked something, I don't know, grip, I don't know, I panicked. And so anyhow, he never said yes, I was right, or no. He was always very positive. He went forward, and we did this for a while. And then one day he asked me to start teaching with him. And what a great honor that was to stand side by side with Jack Lumpkin and teach with him, because he teaches so many great players on the PGA Tour and all the way down to the ranked beginners and juniors. I attempted to make the PGA Tour for 3 years, and he was my instructor, and unfortunately I didn't achieve that. But he thought the world of my game and my talents, and I truly do have to thank Jack for a lot. The GEMSEC family, for all of their help and support for me and also for my family, I want to thank Joe, Frank, and Catherine GEMSEC. In my opinion, one of the smartest decisions the GEMSECs ever made was to hire Dennis Johnson to run Pine Meadow Golf Club. I will say this only once, Dennis. If you know Dennis, you'll understand why I said that. Dennis is an excellent golf professional, just a wonderful person to work for, and is a very special friend. I love you, man. Thank you for your friendship. I also would like to acknowledge my family, were all here tonight. I am so proud of all of them. My brother Bill, actually I'm the youngest of four, we're all 1 year apart. My brother Bill and his girlfriend Kim, my brother Tom and his wife Patty, my brother Patrick and his wife Linda. Patrick and I used to have divot fights when we were young. I can tell you, he hits the biggest divot. I never won. We'd hit them at each other. Trust me, I got hit by enough of them. But what a fun job. That was fun to have. My mother, who has always given me just wonderful advice, and then also my father, who got me started in the game. And this is where I fell in love with the game. We used to go to the field and hit balls, and you'd have your shag bag. And we had an old leather bag, a couple handles on it. And so we'd go out there and hit balls and pick them up. And my dad used to swing the bag, and with his sand wedge, he'd pop it a couple times and catch the ball in the bag. He never missed. It was just the rhythm to watch was just wonderful, and the talent he had. And he helped us all with our golf swings. And Dad, I love you. Thank you very much for getting me started in this game, in a game that I love. Thank you. My daughter here, Samantha, and my son-in-law, Andy, my son Rick, and last but not least, the most important person here tonight for me is my wife. She is my best friend and a sounding board for me. She doesn't always agree with my goofy ideas, but I know I will get an honest answer from her always. And be true to yourself is her statement. She is the backbone of our family, and as a good friend of mine always reminds me, I married up, and that is a true statement. I love you, Kathy. Lord, I thank you for all the gifts and graces you have sent me and for all these wonderful people you have brought into my life. May God bless you all, and have a wonderful evening. Thank you.